Hey boys and girls, instead of me just responding to like all the trailers of the State of Play that was out yesterday night, I decided to just give you guys like a quick summary of what I think. The difference, I'm using my DSLR camera for the first time in quite some time, so hope you guys like the perspective, and I will pop up the occasional gameplay, so don't worry, you're not just gonna see my face, I promise. So, I got my phone, hold on, and I wrote down something that I liked, and a WTF. So, without further ado, let me just like start the list. When I started watching the State of Play, I was just like, what am I doing? I could just go straight to the fucking trailers, because it's the next day. I saw Midnight Walk. Well, this is a game that really talks to me. And I mean it in a way of the style, the aesthetic, the horror. And I do love, for people who have a VR2, that they can switch between just playing the game normally and switch to the VR2 headset. So I believe you just have to redo the checkpoint, or you could perhaps just click in your VR and you can just, you know, play with your VR on. And I think that's a really cool thing that they did, that you can play the game or as, you know, normal game or as with the VR2. But for me, just the whole aesthetic, it kind of reminded me of Little Nightmares a bit. And I just like that. We've seen just a little bit of gameplay of it, so not much, but it speaks to me. Let me just say it like that. Then we have Ghost of Yutai, which I believe is a sequel to Ghost of Tsushima. And when I first saw it, I thought that we're gonna see the main protagonist again from Ghost of Tsushima, right? The original. Since now they go beyond Tsushima, so they go to Yutai. What I saw was the 17th century, so 1600 something, I believe, is where the game is at in terms of age. Color me interested by the way it looked, but I have to ask. So instead of me just like Googling it, I could. But there are some of you who are hardcore fans or experts who are hopefully watching this video when it comes to Ghost of Tsushima. Can you please tell me why they're not using the main protagonist? Because I never played Ghost of Tsushima. I have seen gameplay of it and I loved it, but I never got around playing it because I got such a massive catalog that I still have to go through. So forgive me for that. I'd love to play it, maybe even one day on stream. I don't know yet, but I really want to play because it looks like a phenomenal game, but I just haven't had the time yet to go through it. So forgive me for that. So that's why I'm asking. Is there any particular reason why they're switching protagonists and why it's a woman? Because I thought like the Rowans or samurai in common were just like Japanese men. So if I am wrong here, please tell me. Please correct me in the comment section or elaborate on it. Why they perhaps chose a female Ronin or a female samurai warrior. I believe it's a Ronin, but I'm not 100% sure. So if you guys can please elaborate that to me, I would really appreciate it. But other than that, graphic wise, aesthetic wise, like the whole, all the stuff that they showed, it looked really cool. It really looked like an extension of Ghost of Tsushima from the gameplay that I've seen and from the Twitch content creators that I've seen back then. So it really speaks to me. So secondly, Alan Wake 2, the Lake House DLC. I still have my gripes with Alan Wake 2 because I feel that Alan has become a support character rather than the main protagonist in its own game. Even when it's called Alan Wake, right? And you're playing more as the detective rather than Alan himself. Plus, of course, they race swapped her, which I still don't understand. There's no point in it. They could have easily made a black main protagonist called, I don't know, Ashley Thompson or something, and just have like a black woman pop in. But no, they had to race swap Saga Anderson, who was a blonde woman, by the way. And if you don't believe me, there's like enough footage online where you can see that they kind of teased a sequel to it a couple of years ago. It was a live action teaser where you see Sam Lake's character and Saga Anderson in a detective room. If I can find it, I will pop it here. But if not, just Google it yourself. It's on YouTube. It's everywhere. So it's really weird that they made that switch, but that's because they were being consulted by a Sweet Baby Inc. So that says enough. But anyway, that was my biggest gripe of Alan Wake 2, and of course that Alan is sort of like a side character instead of the main character. And I feel with Lake House, from what I've seen with the little teaser that they've dropped, I feel like it's gonna go exactly the same route as the game itself, where they are just more focused on the detective better than Alan. And I don't like that. I just want to place Alan because, you know, it will be, for instance, if you have Max Payne, you don't place Max Payne, but you play more as like Mona or something. You know, you have like more Mona storyline than Max. No, you want to play as Max Payne because he is the titular hero or the titular protagonist. So it doesn't make any sense to me. And why they're doing that, I don't know. But anyway, I'm still putting it on my pros list because I'm still curious because I love horror. But I just need to see more gameplay of it first before I can really give a full-out opinion on it. But thus far, I have a feeling that it's going to be, as I just elaborated, that it's just going to be purely focused on the Detective Saga Anderson rather than Alan Wake. And yeah, which I find incredibly unfortunate. One of my nicest surprises that I saw was Soul Reaver wanted to remaster. I filled in Crystal Dynamics survey back in the day, and I literally told them at the end when they said like if I wanted to give more information, where I told them like, hey, if you guys want to make a quick buck, first remaster Soul Reaver 1 and 2 first. If you do it and it's a success, then you can always think about either continuing the IP or do a remake. Because people have been waiting for this game for years, and when I saw at the end of the trailer where it says like PS4 and PS5, I was kind of like, are they now gonna put this on PC? What the fuck, right? But then I looked, and yes, it's also gonna come out on Steam and also on Epic Games. So thankfully, it's not an exclusive only on Epic. It's gonna also come out on Steam, so I'm really happy about that. And I really want to play it. It's been years since I played it. And the storyline is great. And I also mentioned this in the survey, by the way. I told them, whatever you do, keep the voice actors. Just enhance the quality of the voices. But please keep the story intact. And they also know that they had to cut certain content off the game because the PlayStation 1 hardware couldn't deal with it. So I hope that they somehow restored it or like made it somehow fit in the storyline. And that they got the original voice actors redo the voices, particularly for that era, in case there is a need of any more storytelling. Because I remember they had to cut out a lot of that because of the memory and stuff that the PlayStation 1 couldn't handle back in the day. So I hope, maybe, but hopefully they could restore some of the lost content or the cut content. That will be super cool. And I think if it fits the narrative of the game, that it could be an extra storyline or extra thing that they could tell in the story. So I think that will be super cool if they are able to pull that off. But we will see. And then the last one is Hell Is Us. When I saw that, it kind of gave me a mixed feeling because I was like, is this going to be like another Souls-like clone? But then I thought of, like Wukong. And I was like, it could be something like Wukong, but then more like sci-fi-ish with more horror elements. So I want to give this a try. You know, from what I've seen, it looks really good. You know, like in-game, like in-game cinematics and gameplay. The storyline also seems to be very, very well done, in my opinion. From what I've seen, like, you know, the little snippets of it. It looks like Death Stranding too, if I'm being honest, like the code and stuff, like the way that they portray the character. So it seems to me, aesthetic-wise, I'm not saying gameplay-wise, aesthetic-wise, it seems to me it's a mixture of, let's say, Wukong with horror, right? And then with a little bit of Death Stranding mixed into that. And that is Hell Is Us. And then the gameplay seems really interesting with you if you had this sort of like drone. So like they can pull you up and then you can like slash down. So I'm really curious. It seems like it has bosses in it and stuff. But we need to see more of it before I can really give a full opinion on it. But from what I've seen, I am actually really interested in it. Other than that, those were kind of like my highlights. And from the other trailers that I've seen, I was like, yeah, I'm not even going to click on it. It doesn't seem interesting to me. So yeah, there were 4 standouts. One's kind of iffy. And then the WTF for me was Horizon Zero Dawn Remaster. Really? Really, Sony? Is that really necessary? Another Horizon? This is like The Last of Us all over again. Last of Us Part 1. Last of Us Part 1 Remaster. Last of Us Part 1 Remake. So when is the remake of Horizon Zero Dawn going to come out? You have so many IPs. People have been begging you for Bloodborne. And you just refuse Bloodborne to just put it out on PC or to even remaster it. I don't know why. I seriously don't know why. And I hope it's still coming because a lot of people have been asking for it. And I think you should really listen to what people want. the original Zero Dawn is good. When you play it, it's good. On PC, it's perfect. You don't need a remaster of it. So, like, what the actual fuck? On top of that, there are also other IPs that Sony can remaster. So, I mean, you also got like Jak and Daxter and stuff. I mean, you guys have got so many IPs laying in the background. You guys are doing anything with it. And I want to know why. What's the point? You can enhance the faces and stuff like they did in Horizon Zero Dawn. Like they enhance the faces, or they grab the motion capture from the Forbidden West and put it on here. Fine, whatever. I don't care. I think the model looked good in Horizon Zero Dawn, and then in Forbidden West, they kind of like altered it a bit more realistic. Fine, whatever. I don't care. But this is such an unnecessary money burner. There's no reason to remaster this or to enhance it. Let me just call it that. It's a shame, Sony. It really is a fucking shame what you guys are doing here. But this is just absurd that you're doing Horizon Zero Dawn remastered version. Like I said, when is the remake? Next year? Tell me. I want to know, because I'm pretty sure if you're going to go the same route as The Last of Us, then there's going to be a remake sooner or later, or maybe even like a TV show, I'm pretty sure. But anyway, all in all, guys, that was my list. I don't want to drag this video out too much. Hope you guys like and subscribe and comment down below, especially on the Ghost of Yutai. Is that what it's called? I hope I'm pronouncing that right. Tell me about that. I'm really curious about more, knowing more about that, like how that, like about the female samurai stuff, if that's actually a thing. Because to me, it seems like I cannot believe that back in the day, in the 17th century, that they would allow women to become samurai or ronin. And it did, by the way, reminded me of Blue Samurai, by the way, the Netflix show, which was actually really good. But I'm just curious. I'm just curious. That's all. Maybe it's fine for most of you. I don't know. It was just a thing that really stood out to me, right? Anyway, all in all, thank you all so much for watching. Appreciate you. We're really close to 2.1K subscribers. We're growing immensely fast. So thank you for that. I really appreciate your support, and the liking and the commenting and the sharing of the videos and just viewing it. Thank you so very, very, very much. And then I'll catch you guys next time. So thank you all so much, and bye bye.